going to get my new book right now, A Spokesman for Men, Real Swagger. You could get the full color edition or the black and white. Get that book now. It's fire.
Ladies, we are the most contradicting species in the world. I'm going to just call it how I see it. We definitely fucked up in the end. Because we get mad. I'm talking about our whole world comes to an end when we find out a nigga cheating on us. But the whole time, we cheating too. Matter of fact, we cheated first. So really, the nigga don't even know he cheating back. See, the difference is we know how to do it and don't get caught. Now listen, it's completely natural for women to go through their man's phone. That's how 90% of y'all niggas get caught. It's not natural for a man to go through his woman's phone. That's why we could be laying right next to you texting another nigga. As long as we lean over every 30 seconds and give you a little mwah, you'll never suspect anything. Ladies, we get so upset. We think whoever this nigga cheating on us with, he may somehow leave us for them. Which is not the case most of the time, because niggas don't catch feelings like we do. But ladies, we think that way because we're doing the same thing. Every time you get mad at your boyfriend, you planning out the rest of your future with the nigga you cheating with, huh? You fantasizing about living with him, what the kids gonna look like, you walk around the house, fake pregnant mom, talking to yourself. Hey, you all, what's
up? All right, shalom, 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 shalom. Good morning. Once again, you're not under the sounds of the voice of your good brother Tyler Doc. I done this last night, but truthfully, man, I'm going to keep it a buck. I was falling asleep doing the call. So I'm here today to, again, introduce you to my new book, A Spokesman for Men, Real Swagger. So this book right here, 200. And by the way, I just released a black and white edition of this. This book is 223 pages. 223 pages. You get it in full color. The full color edition obviously costs a lot more. It costs about $50 more. The full color edition goes for $120 on Amazon. And the black and white edition goes for $55 on Amazon. On the website, it goes for $100 in full color. Full color is going to be a limited edition. And in the black and white, I believe it's $55 on the website, www.truedisciplesofchrist.org. And so why is this book important? To be brief, attraction is not a choice. This book goes into this. A lot of people talking about it. I lived it. Hold on. I forgot to go live over here. A lot of people talked about it. I lived it. But I lived this life. It's nothing to be boastful about, but I learned from my experiences. And I've actually literally had an interaction with more than 1,000 women. Some real pimp shit. You know what I'm talking about? The people around me, the elders around me, taught me the game. I'm going to just keep it real. I'm going to keep it real, Press. You understand what I'm talking about? I'm going to keep it real. Ain't no need for me fronting. So I know a lot of dudes, a lot of simp dudes don't think it's possible. They think I'd be like lying when I say I smashed 1,000 women. I smashed 1,000 females over, you know what I mean? And I'm not bragging about that. That's when I was in the world. When I was in the world, I was really, really out here. You understand what I'm talking about? I was really in the world. And I was really spitting that game. And me always kept my body on point. Always had swagger. You understand? And so the G's around me, the older G's, because I grew up around people that was pimps. I mean real life pimps. And I seen them pimping women. I grew up around hustlers, people that was getting it. Moving packs, moving weight, all of that. By the time I was 6 years old, I already knew how to shoot dice. I was hanging out at crap tables. You understand? They was giving me the game. Now, I'm not telling you to go out and do that, but I think the Most High put me in that vicinity so that I could know the things that I do. And the dudes that I can't, and I always had kept both in the air. Always had a hand game also. Because from a young age, like my cousins and the elders around me, they was already into the martial arts. So by the time I was age 7, I already knew how to throw my hands. From that, they had me doing push-ups, sit-ups, dips, and into the martial arts. So you cannot be a real man, a real G. And the G in this case is for the game. Unless, you know, you could defend yourself. You got to be able to protect yours very well. You can't always run and get that hammer, because if you get on lock, One thing that they taught me, if you ever get locked, you got to know how to put both of them in the air. You understand what I'm talking about, Prez? You're not gonna, you got to know how to put both hands in the air. So this book right here, by the way, go ahead and thumbs up when you come in the room. This book right here goes into all of that, right? Book goes into all of that. First, it teaches you how to attract women, not just any women, but really high value women, women that you thought you could never attract. Right? I'm going to tell you this, man. And listen to me when I tell you this. Attraction is not a choice. The woman could say she don't like you. It's not what she say, man. It's what she does. It's what she do. Don't go for what a lot of these women are saying. Because women don't know what they want. I'm not calling them dodos, but I just know women more than most women know themselves. You hear women come on time at the time saying she want a certain thing, man, or she doesn't like a certain thing. And she do just the opposite. The book goes into this, how to attract not just some bard from the hood, but high value women, like real women that you were supposed to be, quality women. Because at the end of the day, let me tell you something, man. A woman is a woman. See, the problem is, man, I'm gonna tell you where a lot of you guys mess up is when you say, oh, well, she's special, and so on and so. You already slipping. You understand what I'm talking about? Women are, now, women are women, but when you start to value the woman more than yourself, you already lost, man. You already lost. Now, I'm giving you the game. So this book starts off talking about how to attract women. And then in later chapters, I go through, why don't I just run through it real quick? As you see on the first, inside cover, this is the full color version. The full color version is $50 more, and it's worth it. You understand what I'm talking about? As you see, I got the man right there, Yasha Bean. That's one of the people I dedicate this book to, man. Yeah, I mean, never to be a simp again. So chapter one starts off, Let Us Make Man, and I go into some heavy stuff. And in this book right here, I'm actually why I intellectualize a lot of this. I had to keep it hood at the same time for my street cat. You understand? The real niggas, N-E-G-U-S. Not the nigga that you learn to fed. But I'm talking about the real kings, N-E-G-U-S. Ethiopian interpretation of the word nigga. You understand what I'm talking about? So I intellectualize it, but I also keep it hood. I use a lot of slang in the book so I can reach both. I don't want to be one-dimensional because I'm not one-dimensional. I wrote real life in this book. This is not, it's not made up. This is not a comic book. This is not another one of these dudes on YouTube that's talking about, oh yeah, this and that, and he's using, it's theoretical. You could tell the dude really haven't done that. Because how he's moving, he hasn't really done that. These same dudes that be talking tough, if they woman come around, like my man Prez and I was talking about yesterday, they start talking different. Like a lot of you guys, you talk real tough when your woman's not around, but when your woman is around, you don't talk like that. You change it up because you're concerned about what she says, man, instead of like being you. You got to be able to express yourself, man, to your fullest ability. So chapter two talks about attraction is not a choice. Get hot women to chase you. This is real talk right here. What I learned, man, is that a lot of attractive, really hot women are very lonely because a lot of men are afraid to attract, to approach these type of women because of rejection. And one of the things that I learned is that a lot of these women, they act real snobby attitude, but that's part of her test for you. You understand what I'm talking about? That's part of her little defecation test. If you come across as weak, intimidated, that kills attraction. I talk about many of the things in this book that ultimately kills attraction. This really works, man. The things in this book really works. And the beautiful thing about a book is you can read it over and over and over again until you get it. I recommend, if you really want the things in this book to work, you got to read this book 10 times. 10 times. Why? Because repetition is the father of learning. That puts that into your subconscious mind. And you're no longer just reading. It's going into your subconscious, right? So you're going to live that out. You're going to live that out right and exact. So you want to read this at least 10 times. Get the lighting right there. So each time you read it, you're going to acquire something more than you actually had before. I understand a lot of you think you got game, but you think you have game until you read this book, right? This is from years of experience. It's from coming up the way that I did and applying everything. I eliminated all of the things that don't work. And I put in this book the things that work. You could either continue to be prideful, or you could swallow your pride. Go ahead and cop yourself one of these, man. A spokesman for men, real swagger. A spokesman for men, real swagger. This is real swagger for real. So again, it's in black and white, or you can get this full color edition. Now, chapter 3 is G code, gangster code. It talks about body language and how one could actually attract hot women without even talking, just with body language. It teaches you to read. And I'm telling you, man, this is all a game, right? It was something I want to say to you, right? So you hear a lot of people say play checkers or play chess, right? And then they'll turn around and say, I play chess, not checkers. Okay, well, roger that. Taza Doc says, if you're playing checkers or chess, you're still losing. Because think about me, I prefer checkers over chess. Why do you say that, Taza Doc? Because in checkers, the king rules. You understand what I'm talking about? Think about what I'm saying by that, man. Because I always analyze things on a much deeper level than the average Joe, right? So they got you thinking that chess is the, yeah, you wise, you thinking. But objectively, in chess, you want to capture their queen. Because a queen can move all over the board, right? Queen can move all over the board. A king, he can only move one block at a time. Not good. So how is the queen capable of moving throughout the entire kingdom? And the king, because a kingdom belongs to a king, not a queen, right? So you think about this game, the queen is moving all over the board because chess is a feminist game. Taza Doc is the first one that ever said that. That just gave you a plus lesson, man. When you deal with mathematics, everything I say come out right and exact. Yeah? So think about that. Muse over that. So the queen can make far more moves than the king in the game of chess. But in checkers, the king move all over the board. But those are just games. If you really want to learn how to play the real game, it's called life. L-I-F-E. You got to live it out right and exact. And if you don't play the game correctly, you're going to lose. And a lot of you are losing. So this book don't just teach you how to be successful with women. It also teaches women how to be successful with men, how to attract the high-value male. And the high-value men are very limited. But it also teaches you how to win in life, how to have the power of positive thinking. Because if your thinking is coming from a low level of vibration, you're never going to be what the supreme Elohim intended you to be. You understand what I'm talking about? Your thinking is not in the right place. And so what I learned about women also, women, they act a lot. They want to come across as very, you know, intelligent. They're very argumentative. But all of that is just a shield, man. When you break that down, she's just some frail, scared woman that's been, usually most women, especially so-called black women, suffer some sort of abuse and needs counseling, right? They either been, I'm just keeping it real, huh? They either been sexually abused, mentally abused, you got daddy issues. This book goes into how to deal with these kind of women, man. It teaches you how to deal with these kind of women. And if you men, every man in America should read this book, irregardless of your color, because if you don't, you're going to simp up and you're going to end up getting divorced rate in one of these colorable courts. So the book talks about that also. Now, chapter 4, it talks about how to get your ex back. Why would a man want to go back and get an ex? I don't know. I don't move like that. If I'm done, I'm done. To go back is not productive. I'm always soaring to new heights. So why would anyone want their ex back? I don't know. I can't figure it out. But there's a lot of dudes out there hurting. They're in pain because a woman left them. And in most instances, it's usually always the woman that leaves. Why are you guys trying to go and get it back? For a woman? Really? You're the prize. Women don't like when I say this, but it's real. I want to tell all men out here, man. Listen, man. You are the prize. And you need to remember that. You're the prize, man. The Most High said, let us make man in our image after our likeness. He's talking about the Most High and his son, man. You're made in the image and likeness of the Most High, but you let a woman rule over you? That's how you know that the system is off as hell. And all these women that claim to be Christians, when I talk like this and it offends you, I know your spirit is off. You reading scriptures, you wake up in the morning, you reading little passages from the Bible. That don't mean a damn thing to you because you're not living that out. Let me tell you women something, right? Every single one of you women that's with a man, that man is your covering according to the Most High. In the very moment that you stop listening to that man, you are out from under your protection and you started a journey of wickedness. You've aborted the path, and this man has to be in tune with the Most High. If you were some worldly Negro, you already F-U-C-K-E-D. You understand what I'm talking about? And I'm not talking about on those carousels that you've been on. I mean by the system in general in your head and your cerebral cortex. Because the man is your covering. Most High tells us that the leader of my people are men. So all of you so-called Christian women out there and Israelite women out there, understand that. You're to be taught and guided by your head. Your man is your head. You're covering. Why do you got a problem with that? But you have problems with yourselves and you don't get it. You really don't get it. And I can't make this shit up, Price. They don't get it. You women can't see that there's something very wrong if you're always blaming a man. But it's not the man. The man is supposed to be a leader. And you need to calm the hell down and allow him to read. And my book talks about that, man. And the more men that read this book, the less you're going to be able to go on OnlyFans and exploit sex. Esau got a wicked system where he allows you to legalize prostitution through a website. They don't care as long as they get paid. Don't you realize you're selling your soul? How many fiat currencies did you sell your soul for today on OnlyFans for a fiat currency? That's going to get you death. You're going to burn. You're going to find out that Hamashiach Yahushua, the one that you ignorantly call Jesus Christ, is verb. And upon return, a lot of you women are going to die, man. I'm telling you, according to the Bible, most of you are not going to make it, man. Most of you talking back to your husband, you're not going to make it. Because first Ephesians 5 and 22 through 24 tells you to obey your husband as you would do Yahweh. You know what you call that? You call that God. So you tell me how you're going to make it in the kingdom if you're given a directive to obey your husband as you do the Most High, and you're running off at the damn mouth. You wicked, man. Then you get upset when a man calls you wicked. You are wicked. You're wicked. You don't want to acknowledge it. I can't make this shit up, Wes. I can't make this up, man. And you don't want to acknowledge it. You know why? Because the devil, you got a piece of the devil's pie. You're eating on the devil's pie, and you're following the Esau system. But when you already, this system's already starting to fall, man. You could damn near do anything you want in this modern Babylon, this modern Sodom. You understand? I think they call part of it Harlem. This is a modern side, man. Everything you had a dude come on my platform last night, Prez. But you, so I like how the black man's imprint of his D-I-C-K is showing. I want to suck it. This some dude from the LGBT QRSTUVWXYZ community. You understand what I'm talking about? How you gonna put something like that on a platform, man? Sodomites coming to the platform, man. Now, check this out, though. I'm gonna show you how devil standard and wicked this system is. When someone speak out against that lifestyle, YouTube's ready to, you know, flag the account. Yeah, I mean, put you on a 2-week suspension. But this is why I am a spokesman for men. Because if you say something to women, they're ready to flag you. You say something to these alternative lifestyles or someone that's a sodomite, they're ready to flag you. But you can say any damn thing you want to a heterosexual male. And yo, they just laugh at it. You know why? Because there is a conscious intention to emasculate the strong male figure. They want you emasculated. They're content once most of you are like women. You are getting a lot. Let me tell you something, man. I say this and I stand on this. My book talk about this, man. 98% of men out there, you got effeminate energy. Why? Because there's such a high percentage of you was raised by women. Even if you was raised by a single mom, right? If you had the benefit of having other men around that was like a father figure or role model, then you still might be good. So some of you might be good, but most of you are not. And I could tell how bitchy you get. This is why so many dudes come around me, man. They be real damn emotional, man. Yeah, I mean, they can't handle it when I talk to them like a real man. They run. Oh, yeah, he hurt my own like how he talked, man. He don't seem like a cohort. He seemed more like a general. Well, I'm a damn warrior, man. I got a warrior spirit. You understand what I'm talking about? You can't handle that because you're too much into your feminine energy. So then when I start speaking, you bitch out here. Yeah, then you get emotional, start throwing your hair around. It's happened time and again, man. It happened time and again. Because you acting like a broad because you was raised by a dinky broad. Your mom is dizzy because she was on that carousel. You seen your moms bring in this woman. I mean, that man, she might have born a woman. That man, not your father. Then the dude, the dude had homosexual tendencies, so he was touching on you also, even though you was a boy. My book talks about all of that, man, because a lot of you need healing. You understand what I'm talking about? So, chapter 5, it talks about trans grooming to a high-value male. A high-value male, thumbs up as you come in the room, a high-value male is a very distinct thing. It's a dying breed. But again, most men are not high value. The people that refer to themselves as alpha males, these dudes have a lot of problems also. I often refer to them as fake alphas. They act tough. They act real tough. Tougher than normal, right? You can tell when a dude is stunting, Prez, because a real man don't have to try and convince nobody, yeah, I'm tough, man, I'm alpha male. You don't have to be, you know what I mean, always emphasizing that. You're saying that because you're insecure. You're trying to convince someone that you are alpha. So then you OD with it. You be mistreating women, talking to them like they, oh yeah, get over there, bitch. Talking to them for no reason. Just he want to come off as tough guy. That'd be the same dude that be, he'd be a gym rat. He in the gym all of the time. He ain't got no life, man. He's just in the gym trying to get brawling. But he's not really an alpha by head. So, I mean, his body and everything might be on point, but he's a fake alpha. Because he's trying, see, a fake alpha, let me tell you something different, man, between Taz and Doc and a fake alpha. Thumbs up as you come in the room. Let me tell you something different between me and a fake alpha. And this book talks about that, is that a real man of high value, he works out for his health and to make himself look better. He want to be at his best. He's not doing it for a woman. See, most of these dudes, let me hit you something, man. Most of these dudes, when they go to the gym, they in the gym to try and impress females. They walking out. He looking in the damn mirror at a female. He walking out. Yeah, it was supposed to be legs day, press. This is why a lot of them got a Popeye built. They got a big upper brolic body. And when they legs, they skinny as hell, man. Like they're about to fall over. And that robs your body and power. So it's supposed to be legs day. He go in and he see a woman come in there. Now she got a fake chest. You know what I mean? Her boobs are fake. She got some fake hips. She got lip injections. She just got back from the Dominican Republic. And she looking right. But now this dude, he looked, damn, sure he looked right. He's about to change his entire regimen for that woman over there that's made up. She didn't work out for that body. She's not eating right for that body. She went into someone's office, man, and got surgery for that body. You understand what I'm talking about? Just like your alternative lifestyles. But he's going bonkers over that. So you just change your entire workout regimen to try and impress someone that's made the hell up, man. That's what I'm talking about. You dudes are like broads, man. Hey, Shalom, Matrix. You dudes are like broads. That's what I'm talking about. And I'm speaking to a lot of you right now. You'd be like, damn, you're talking about, you got me. But you want to admit it. You want to vocalize it loudly. Viva voce. But inside, you know I'm cutting your spirit because you like this. You'd be in the gym doing that, man. You over there trying. When I go to the gym, man, I have on my head. I don't talk to nobody. I'm in the zone. Get my workout on. Get out of there. I don't need to be in a lot of. Why am I in the gym? When one of these little crazy dudes might try and step to me, man, I defend mine very well. You understand what I'm talking about? You run up and get done up. Stay on point, man. You always got to stay on point, man. I stay in war mode. I'm not in the gym trying to impress some chick. So I ain't got no time for that, man. I'm on my purpose. And the book talks about that. Because you gym rat. You've been in the gym all damn day. And I'm going to tell you something, man. You attract women on the principle that she feel protected because you're big and muscular. And that only gets it for a while. Because you want to feel safe. That goes back to ancient times when women were actually looking for protectors. They don't even know what she doesn't even know what she's attracted to you. But that's the reason. This is why a lot of women are attracted to tall men, because she feel as though he can protect her, man. But we'll break his ass down, man. Just like a shotgun. You understand what I'm talking about? The horde they fool. You understand? The horde they fool, man. Because I got the heart of a lion and the courage of 10. That's what it is, man. Biggie told you a long time ago, man. Ain't no shook hands in Brooklyn. Look, man. Forget all of that, man. We don't care how much you pump, man. So, chapter 6 talks about the things your mother never told you about women. And this is essential because it goes into all of these personality disorders that a lot of women have. See, let me tell you, man, something, man. The reason, and again, those of you that are just coming in, go ahead and give a thumbs up. I'm talking about my new book, A Spokesman for Men. You can get it on my website, truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop. You can click below the video link and you can go ahead and cop the book. You can also get it on Amazon. I prefer you get it on the website. I'll give you a better deal. It's going to be in black and white either today or tomorrow. Right now, it's only available in full color. The black and white edition is going to be half the price. This full color edition is going for $120 on Amazon, $100 on the site. You say, Taz Doc, that's a lot for the book. No, it's not, man. Now, the information that you get out of here is really going to change your life. And once you read this book, every one of you that read this book, go on Amazon and write a review. Marty Mar, you already got the book. I don't know why you ain't picking up your phone, homie, man. I hope you ain't get upset and emotional over the little lollipop jokes we was making, man. Come on, man. Man up, man. I hit you up a few times yesterday. And I understand my man Prez hit you up yesterday. You ain't pick up your phone, man. I hope you okay, man. I mean, you could at least respond with a text or something and say I'm good, man. That's a respectful thing to do, man. But getting back to this, Bob. So once you get this book, go on Amazon and write a review. And it's got to be positive because this is real fire right here. This is real food for thought. This is real fire. This is right knowledge for real. A spokesman for men, real swagger. Go on Amazon, write a review, man. And it's available all over the world, man. We're just laughing at Matrix, man. I'm just keeping it real, man. Yo, man. Yo, Money Mob, we don't see you on here soon, man. I'm gonna mail you a bag of blow pops, man. Out there where you are in Cali, man. You know I mean? So, chapter 6 goes into how a lot of women, believe it or not, and a lot of you men, you're with these women now. Thumbs up as you come in the room, family. Thumbs up as you come in the room. A lot of these women have personality disorders. They have daddy issues. Some of them mean they have mother issues. Yeah, I've been with a couple women where they didn't even get along with their mothers because their mothers had issues and there was like a coldness. Like when I went around them, like, damn, Mitch, how you ain't talking to your moms? Like I had a better relationship with her moms and I could engage more in conversation than she could. And so you know that's going to be a problem, man. When a woman can't get along with her moms, man, that's a real problem, man. The scriptures say, man, in the book of Ezekiel, man, 44:16, as the mother, so is the daughter. So if the mom, you know what was out there on that carousel, you could best believe, man, unless some spiritual man came into that daughter's life and saved her, man, by putting her in these scriptures, so is the daughter, man. The daughter's going to be just like that, if not worse. In fact, these women are taught this from an early age by their mothers, their peer groups, their aunts, and big mom. Girl, don't you get caught down on one man. If he wants something from you, if he wants that stuff between your legs, if he wants some of your box, you be sure to get something from him. What are you teaching her how to do right there? That's known as prostitution, man. And this is why a lot of you dudes, man, you come home from work, your damn house smells like prostitution, man. Because your wife, you can't even leave town for a few days, man, because your wife is wicked. Then she's sitting down, she's reading the Bible and all this, reading scriptures. What a real hypocrite, man. I can't wait, Prez, until Hamashiach returns, man, to set this place, burn this Babylon, man, this modern Babylon. I can't wait until the judgment of the Most High, man. I'll be fasting and praying, Most High, please show these women, man, how they out of line. Because they really think they're in order. You don't understand, you're in the Esau system, man. The Most High said the leader of my people are men. The 144,000 purified one are all men. This is Bible, man. You understand what I'm talking about? Mr. Evans, thumbs up as you come in the room, man. And feminists don't like this, man. Because the feminist agenda is being pushed around and men are getting divorced rate almost every time they go in court. Oftentimes, the man is the better parent. How am I able, case in point, man, how am I able to sue my children better than their own moms? It's not supposed to be like that. These are things that you were supposed to learn at home from your mother. And if you wasn't taught that, it's not the man's fault. You don't learn that from YouTube. You don't learn that from your man. You're supposed to already know that. And until you acknowledge that you have a problem with these type of issues, man, it's not going to damn change, man. You guys need counseling, man. And your counsel needs to come from the Most High through your husband. But you don't want to listen. You don't want to humble yourself, so you're going to burn according to the Bible. You're going to burn. And you can like that, understand it, believe it or not. You're going to find out that the Most High is real, man. And I fast and I pray when I see the day, man, when this thing starts taking place, man. I can't wait, man, for the kingdom to come, man. And I can witness this and say, damn. And they can start saying, damn, yeah, this is right, man. Tazadok was prophesying correctly. You're going to burn with fire. You're missile fool. according to the Bible. So the book in chapter 6 teaches you how to avoid borderline personality disorders and narcissistic personality disorders. Chapter 7 talks about how select women can meet and keep a high-value man. A lot of you women complain about no good men, right? Where are you going to meet a man? You went to meet the man at the club. You went to meet the man at a party. What the hell you think the man's there for, man? He's there for a one-hitter quitter or a side piece or something like that. A banger, man, that he just want to bang out. And the man's going to sell you. Let me give you some game, Bob. The man's going to tell you whatever he thinks you want to hear, man. So he hit that. And so I'm going to tell you, man, because I was out there in the game doing that, man. You understand what I'm talking about? Because unless you got a man that really fears the Most High, man, if the man have a woman at home and his woman don't want him to have another woman because he's really simping, that's kind of like low simping because he's allowing the woman to dictate to him, then he's going to keep making you promises. Yeah, I'm going to leave her. I'm going to leave her. This shit been going on for like 4 or 5 years, and you still believe in that. And then when you finally come to the conclusion and realize that, damn, he's not leaving his wife for me, then you get mad. So let me tell you something, man. That means something's wrong with you, boo. You understand? That means something's wrong with you because you went through that for 4 or 5 years, and you didn't walk away from it. You understand what I'm talking about? You stayed there because you needed help. That proves that you're unhealthy. Let me ask you this, man. All you women that don't have the kind of man you want, why? Because something's wrong with you. It's something in your personality that turns him off. And the man said, nah, you're not wifey material. You understand what I'm talking about? I know it's painful to admit, but this is real. Chapter 8. How this chapter is, it goes into how to practice polygamy lawfully, legally, and biblically without being charged with bigamy. Now you can't use phrases like this is my wife, this is my second wife. Because they came at the Mormons and all of these people that use these terms. So this chapter, it goes into the legality of it, how to literally have more than one mate and not be charged with bigamy. That chapter alone should sell this book. Thumbs up as you come in the room. Thumbs up as you come in the room. And again, this book is also available in black and white. In chapter 9, how to stop being a thirsty beta simp male. There's too many thirsty beta simp men out here, right? You're thirsty. So, I mean, what I mean by that is that you see a woman, she look right. You say, damn, she look right in them yoga pants. She got them on. Because first of all, she wants to make other women jealous. That's why they come to the gym and that crap. Yeah, I mean, you can see everything. No room for imagination, right? Even when I was single, man, the only thing you could get from me, man, is me to smash you. You couldn't even get my seed. And if I had the wisdom that I knew, not half of these women would have never had my seed in them. You're not worth my seed. You understand? I'm a real king, man. A real niggas, N-E-G-U-S, man. And most of you women, you're not even worthy of me, man. The ones that I laid back in the day. You wasn't even worthy of my time. If I had the knowledge that I had now, man. But I had to learn through trial and error. And now that I learned, I'm giving the game to other men that just, you really haven't had a real man in your life. You mourning. The woman, and these women, they come on, they brag about, yeah, I broke up with him. So then what, ho? Why are you not married? She broke up with him. And what? What are you going to do? Jump on the carousel again? Jump on another ride? That go for a few years, if that, or a few months? And boom, you off on the carousel again. You know what you're doing? You're lowering your value each time you did that. Your value becomes lower and lower. Nobody wants that. You've been passed. Them shit's been passed all around, man. Nobody wants that. You understand what I'm talking about? The only thing you're for, man, is really a sperm bank. Let me just keep it real. And if he's wise, he's not even going to make no deposits of sperm in that bank. You understand what I'm talking about? He's gonna strap it up. Because, I mean, he's going to realize, damn, she's not worth that. She's been around. So, men, wise up, man. Cop this book. I tell you, man, attraction is not a choice. It's not a choice. Read this book before she does. Read it before she does. Get it. Go and cop it and read it before she does. And you women that want to learn how to keep a real high-value man, how to get one, keep one, the limited ones there is, and some of you are going to have to settle. That's the bottom line. You're going to have to settle for a man, because if a man is a high-value man, do you really think he cares about you leaving? Especially if you've got children, who are you going to be playing games with yourself, saying, okay, he's going to accept my children as their father would. You out of your damn mind. Let me tell you, man, this is why there's so many children out here that's been sexually abused. Don't you know that usually comes from a stepfather, a stepmother? Who's doing that? You are. You're leaving the relationships. My book goes into that, man. How, you know, women typically leaves the relationships and these children get exposed to all of this abuse through some step-parent, right? Which would, you know, that would have likely not to have happened if the father was present in that child's life. But you didn't care anything about that. You know what you do? Because you got daddy issues, you blame the man. But you wouldn't submit to him. You consider yourself a Christian woman, or unless you're one of them hotep hoes, but you wouldn't submit to him like the scriptures order you to. And a lot of you can't receive this. Like the woman that came out, I would like to, I would like your wife to write a book. Get your fat ass up out of here. And you fat. Instead of coming over here, giving a comment, get me to teach you how to lose damn weight, to lose that damn gut. And I can usually tell if you fat by your face, by your facial feature. And let me tell you something, man, about these fat chicks. They put a pic of just a headshot. That right there is a dead giveaway. I'm giving you guys the game. That usually means she's fat. She's overweight. You understand what I'm talking about? So she just give you a headshot. And you're down here complaining. You know how you complain in press? Because they're miserable. That's why they only here complaining. You fat. But you always got something to say. You won't come on because you know I'm going to ear your ass out. So I talk about that in my book, man. She can't control, you know what I mean? She can't control her mouth with what comes out of it. And obviously you can't control what's going in it. That's why you're so damn fat and overweight. And so now we got a problem in America where what? 8.5 out of 10 is overweight. And I'm going to say 8.5 because a baby in your stomach, you overfeeding them. So when you're pregnant, you use that as an excuse to balloon up. You look like the damn Goodyear blimp. You understand what I'm talking about? Well, when you get pregnant. So instead of you just gaining 25 pounds, you gained 50, 60 pounds. And then when you had the baby, oh, that's baby fat. Hold on, are you grown? You shouldn't have gained any more than 20 to 25 pounds at most. And then when you see the so-called white woman, she had the baby, she out in the gym, she walking out. You know what I mean? The Asian woman, she walking out. The Negro woman, I just had a baby. I can't. She don't want no exercise. She don't want to do nothing, man. You take the baby, do some damn squats or something, man. Get off of your fat behind, man. Take 10,000 steps a day. Lose that damn gut. But you can't tell a Negro woman a damn thing. And she's the one that usually running off at her mouth, man. And that's when she get upset when the other women, when women of other nations, oh, the black man, he wants the women of the other nation. Because they more humble you than your ass. You don't have to keep your mouth closed. Of all, other people have their issues. But of all nations, the black woman, your damn mouth is more out of control than any other woman on this planet. And this is why your ass is most lonely. And this is why you're the most, and I'm not going to be one of them dudes, man, like them Hotep Negroes that come on here and try to uplift you. You off as hell, man. I'll be glad when the Most High comes back and turn this thing up on your ass, man. Real talk, man. I shoot all prayers, man, that the Most High speed this up, man. So these women can really see what's going on, man. You take a man's, my book goes into that, how you take a man's children out of his life. And oftentimes the system knows that. Esau's system knows that, man. Because systematically, it's designed to destroy us. And to destroy the unit of family, the only thing you need to do is to remove the man. You've already proved that. You've proven that already. You understand what I'm talking about? Because you fell. And we can see that from all of these gangs. You understand? We can see that from these teenage pregnancy. We can see that because you look down at your organ. You don't even know what sex you are. You're confused. And when I talk like this, you call it hate speech, but it's true. You understand what I'm talking about? You're operating on a demonic system, man. A demonic system that you're going by what the system said. You women that be up in a man's grill, blocking doors and all of that, you do that because your support system, your God, is the Edomite man. Because you're going to call 911 because you wouldn't do that, man. If that, you know what I mean? You knew that if you call 911, man, like it was back in the 70s, said, I can't do nothing, man. That's a domestic dispute. We got to stay out of that. See, them getting in a man's family business is a new thing. And this is why the so-called black woman is out of order. You're out of order, man, because you got a slice of the devil's pie. But you're going to find out that pie is rotten, man. It's rotten. So this is why I'm a spokesman for men, man, because there's nobody out here for men, man. Nobody. And that could be a so-called black man, so-called white man, so-called whatever, man. If a man goes into this court system, man, unless he know the stuff that I know, man, boom, man. You getting divorced, right? That means you're going to lose most of your substance, man, that you work all your damn life for. Then a woman came into your life, man. This is what this book's about, man. This book is to prevent you from making these. Let me take my gazelles off, man. That's what this book's about, man. This book is about you not thinking you're so in love. Because when a man starts saying he's in love, yo, that's a fool right there, man. You're making yourself real vulnerable, man, unless you're still in control. Because these women will ice you, man. They will ice you. Because in the back of her mind, the reason they talk like they talk, how you in my crib running off at your mouth and I'm feeding you and clothing? Are you crazy? I'm feeding you and clothing you and everything, but you running off? You disrespecting a man? He's paying for anything? What kind of, you're a wicked damn demon. You're a devil. You understand what I'm saying? Then you get upset and deny you're a goddamn devil. I don't say I curse. I say goddamn. Goddamn devil is just a devil that God has damned. You understand? So it's not cursing. If I send curses out, that's going to be prayers that something happened to you. Understand that. So understand the linguistics of words. Don't say I curse. But this is real right here, man. This is real, and it needs to be hard. Because that's what's going on, man. Too many dudes, man, too many men has been ravaged by this gynocentric court system. And when people start talking like that, they, oh, he's a misogynist. He's like toxic masculinity. He's too toxic. No, I'm a real man. A very distinct creature. I'm the last of a dying breed. You understand what I'm talking about? I'm the last of a dying breed, man. Real talk. Last of a dying breed. And more men, if more men had my mindset and was willing to stand up, you could get out of this thing. But it's not really about that, man. You're about trying to impress Eve. You're about catering to the woman, trying to oppress the woman. This world's out of order, man. This is why I fast and I pray when the Most High comes back and bring judgment, man. I fast and I pray, man. These women, most women, you are not going to make it. Yeah, you women call yourself Christians in Israel. You're not going to. Why read the Bible, man? The Bible tells you, it gives you a directive. Orders. Genesis 3 and 16. And thou desire shall be unto thy husband, and he shall rule over you. What don't you get about that? You understand all that? You just wicked. I don't give a damn what you can't talk to me after that, man. That's the creator, the supreme Elohim telling you that. Ain't a damn thing you can say to me after that, because I don't want to hear it. I understand who I am as a man, and I understand that the spirit of the Most High and his son resides in me. And he made me higher than you. I don't give a damn if you vice president or whatever, man. That's into the devil system. Because Hamashiach told us that the prince of this world cometh and have nothing in me. John 14, verse 30. Has nothing in me. Who's ruling this world, man? The USA. Under Satan's authority. USA. Under Satan's authority. Job 9 and 24 told you that the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. There's a wicked cabala that's ruling this earth. And he covered the faces of the judges thereof. Suddenly, Christ looks like Charles and Manson. Cedric Bozier. Interesting. Nope, not by accident. Now, suddenly, color doesn't matter. But they still writing you tickets for driving through a red light. Yeah, but they tell you color doesn't matter. Where they do that at? They only does that in Simpville. Because that's the only one that's going for that. So when a real man like me start talking this talk, I turn it off. Turn your speakers up. Turn it up. So you can hear me clearly. But there's an order in this earth, man. You understand? And that order is 1 Corinthians 11 verse 3. That order is God the Father, God the Son, man, then woman. That's a divine order. And when you break that order, when you try to change that order as America has and as this world has, that's when you get chaos. That's when you get a man going into a damn court. This man's been working all his life. And because she gave him her box that's been passed around, now she's entitled to half of that man's substance, so she could go and lay up with another damn man, you no good. I can't even say it about her. I can't even say it. But you men better wake up, man. That's what this book's about. That's why I wrote this book. Don't think this book is not important as a law book, man. This book is as important as those are, because it's teaching you how to be a real man. Why did I feel compelled to write this? Because of Ruach HaKadosh told me, tell the dark, write this book. Because most men don't know this stuff. Most men has been reared by women, especially in the so-called black community, or as they say, conscious community. You conscious, but you teaching your damn woman she could go around and have multiple men. What the hell is that about? And any woman that come to me saying anything like that already know you're screwed. Not just between the legs, but in your head also. You feel me? You're screwed. You're damned. You're condemned. You're condemned already. Understand what I'm talking about? You women don't want to hear this. And listen, man, let me make this clear. This is only for women that this applies to. Not all women, but you're really getting close to the borderline. Not all women does this apply to, but most of you, it does apply to, right? Some of you have more to offer than a buck. Some of you are very strong, because I'm going to tell you something, man. This is a secret. A woman that is supportive of a man, that's going to support that man, that's not going to embarrass him. Like when you talk back, you're already out of line. You understand? When you talk back, oh, you ain't my dad. Yeah, I'm more than your dad. I'm your damn husband. You understand what I'm saying? The Most High says you should leave your mother and your father and become one with your husband. And he shall rule over you. Genesis 3 and 16. Honor your husband like you would Yahweh. They use the word Lord. How you going to get out of that? What you going to say when you go before judgment and you haven't done that? And your ass burned with fire. You're going to be liquidated by the weapons of the Most High for not listening, for wanting to follow a feminist agenda. Because most women in this society, you're feminists. You're under a feminist agenda. The Most High told you, man, and Tazer Doc is telling you in this book, a spokesman for men. Look at it. Get a clear shot at it. You see that? A spokesman for men. Real swagger. See that swag? A spokesman for men. Real swagger. The Most High told you, man. Last book, right, of the Old Testament. Let me show you something, man. Can't make this thing up, man. The last book in the so-called Old Testament, should I say. He's telling you what must be done to fix society. Let's see what he said. Because the system is teaching you that the children go with the women, not with the men. But let's see what the Most High says. Let's see what the Supreme Elohim of the universe says. I had the book of Malachi. Last chapter, last verse. And he shall turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, not the hearts of the mothers, Mr. Esau. Not the hearts of the mothers. The children are not to go with the mothers. And he shall turn the hearts of the fathers, the men, to the children, and the hearts of the children to the fathers. This is why it's in a man, the baby's crying, the man go and pick up his, I go and pick up my son, he calms down. He can feel my heartbeat. He feels the rhythm of my heartbeat. There's a connection there. The mom, I don't know what to do. This baby won't stop crying. He's not connected with you. That's fulfilling the scriptures. The man goes right there. He calms down. Even if it's a daughter, his daughter calms down. That's prophetic. Because the Most High has put a curse on you because of your rebelliousness, which is witchcraft. According to 1 Samuel 15:23, rebelliousness is like witchcraft. And he shall turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the hearts of the children to the father. Least, meaning or else, I come and I smite the earth with a curse. So now this didn't happen. So what happened? The earth has been smite with a curse. What's the curse? There's a new thing in the earth. There's a new thing in the earth. A woman shall compass a man. That means she's elevated. Now you got a woman vice president. And if Sleeping Joe falls over, she's going to be voted in office as the president. Right? Right? Get you that precept, man. There's a new thing in the earth. A woman shall compass a man. That means the woman is going to raise up and be higher than the man. Book of Isaiah. Isaiah 43 and 19 says, behold, I would do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it. I will even make a way in the wilderness, in rivers, in the desert. So he's going to make a way for the men. He's going to make a way for the men. But as for now, that curse, there's a woman shall compass the man. And that's what's going on in this earth. The women, Jeremiah 31 and 22 is being fulfilled. This system has actually lifted the woman up above the man. You go into a court system, man gets divorce rate. The man is losing all of his substance. Some men put their entire lives into this. Their entire life. And what happens? He loses it all within the blink of an eye. Within the blink of an eye, the man loses it all. Jeremiah 31 and 22 in effect. In full effect. He lost everything. Some of you, I'm talking to some of you right now because you're in a really dark place because you went to court and you got divorce rate. The Most High asked the question. He calls you backsliding daughters. How long will you backsliding daughters? When you nation of Yasha'ullah. I'm going to put it on the screen so you can see it, man. I can't make this up. I don't believe it says that. What verse is that? I had Jeremiah 31 and 22. How long will thy go, O backsliding daughter? For the supreme Elohim have created a new thing in the earth. A woman shall compass a man. That's the curse right there. That's the curse. Now they've elevated her above the man and it messed her head up. She wants power. She wants equality. Even though the man built these things, she wants to own them. Even though she can't go out there and do it on her own, she wants to control it. Oh, I sound like a chauvinist? No, man. I'm waking men up. I'm a spokesman for men. This is real talk. You got females all in the psychology and psychiatry industry, and they're no longer saying, they're no longer admitting that typically the number one people with borderline personality disorder is the womb man. They took it out. They say it's too offensive. They don't want the truth. They want political correctness. But that's not tied to Doc overhead. You get the truth, not political correctness. And you shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free. St. John 8 and 32. But you put a little bit of ties of doctrine in there, the truth will make you mad. They make you free. Why are you mad right now? Well, damn, I don't want to hear from him. I don't want to hear from him. What about, let me hear from his wife. Because you don't want the truth. You understand what I'm saying? Hold on a second here. So in conclusion, man, I'm going to go ahead and tell you to go ahead and cop the new book, man. You could get it on Amazon or you could get it on my website, www.truedisciplesofchrist.org. I'll go ahead and throw it in the room again one more time. And those of you on IG, I'll list it under this. This is a new book in full color, but you could also cop it in black and white. So once again, this is Tyler Doc. This is Shahawaswa. I'm going to say Shalom. Shalom. How about Shalom? Shalom.